Hello, friends and family of First CRC. It's Pastor Moses. It's wonderful to come back to you with this week's Midweek Thoughts. Over the month of May, we had our growing young team lead the Midweek Thoughts as we went about talking about mentorship. And finally, here I am back speaking with you here on Thursday. This past week has been a very solemn week. A lot of our attention has gone towards what the premier was going to share in terms of how we opened up society again, coming out of this third wave. But another big important news that was carried along the news waves, along social media, and probably among, you know, coffee conversation is the discovery of 215 human remains at the Kamloops Residential School. And it has impacted a lot of us. It's impacted the church, it's impacted the community, it's brought back some of those emotions that were shared when the Truth and Reconciliation report came out. And I was thinking for today, what might it mean for us? What might it mean for us that's, you know, halfway across the country, for a lot of us who probably don't have any personal experience or relationship with residential schools? You know, some of you were probably born after the last residential have closed. Maybe some of you, you know, have no recollection of it because, yeah, you know, it hasn't been part of our framework here in the Christian Reformed Church. So for us, who may not necessarily be connected to it, what should our response be? What should my response be? Is it simply to call out the churches that have done those acts of injustice or those people that has led that? I think one of the things that God is calling us to do is into a ministry of reconciliation. Ministry of reconciliation. Now, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 has a lot to say to that. And we know some of those passages really well. But today I just want to read from verse 18, chapter 5. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. One of the things that we want to do here at First CRC here in Barrie is to grow in love for God and our neighbor. And you know, so many times I mentioned that we do such a good job in growing in love for God. And I wonder if this is that opportunity when we can grow in love for our neighbor, our immediate neighbor, our neighbors in our immediate neighborhood, our neighbors here in Barrie, but our fellow neighbors who walk this land, who have experiences of pain, who feel that there has been injustice that has been done, corporate injustice that has been done into their lives. And for us to simply remain silent and to just continue doing what we're doing, I wonder if we have missed that calling that God has given us to be instruments of change and instruments of reconciliation here in this world. Now, I'm not sure if any of you are related to any of those 215 unnamed people. Probably not. But we, each and every single one, are those who have been created in the image of God. We are fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. And so, if they are hurting, I am hurting. We are hurting. And it is our hope, it is my hope, and it is my desire that we as a congregation can also join in lamenting, in crying, and asking for God's justice to be revealed here on this earth, and especially this week in Kamloops, British Columbia, as that community continues to mourn. This week, the Indigenous ministry here in the Christian Reformed Church here in Canada has released a prayer that laments what we're going through right now. And I hope that you will join with me as we join in that prayer.
Hi, my name is Victoria. I'm a white CRC member on a journey of reconciliation.
I am Shannon, and I am a Saizi Dene First Nation woman. In response to the recent news of the 215 children buried in unmarked graves at a residential school in Kamloops, BC, we offer this prayer for yourself and your church community.
Even when we don't recognize it, we know that when one part of the body suffers, every part suffers with it. So in this prayer, we come together as the body, asking for our collective healing as we bear one another's burdens. Please join us in prayer now. Creator acquainted with all our griefs, it is a crime, a loss, a shock, an evil, and a tragedy all in one for 215 lives to be cut short, to have to grieve deaths that did not have to be, the disregard for life in clear violation of your good commandment. O Christ, where is the justice that could ever make this right when no one can restore what has been taken?
We are ever mindful of the harm that could come to others that we love. I fear that harm might come to me. Creator, how do we create safety when our loss is built on harmful systems? We surely cannot change what happened or make sense of it or find some lesson in it. And so we are left feeling vulnerable with reopened wounds as we seek ways to bring healing to our community. Be our shield and defender. Hold us in this hour. Hold us through this long, dark night when death's shadow obstructs the light. Cradle and carry us through this veil of sorrows. Deliver us to higher ground. Let justice roll down, O Christ.
Help us to see where we have sinned individually and collectively, to identify the causes of injustice and to move towards change. We are too weak to walk this path alone or to power through by force of our own will. So send your Holy Spirit to strengthen us now.
We know, O God, that you would have us be completely honest in our words to you, voicing even these discouragements and volatile emotions. And you are more than able to bear their weight, never wavering in your constant love and care for us. For you, O God, watched one you love die violently, your only son. You sympathize with us, so we will freely speak to you the depths of what we feel. We would be honest in our pain. Help us not to become the walking sum of all our pain. Now let us come to you, uncovering these wounds as often as we need, and learning how to offer them to you that you might minister your grace to us.
Now shape us, Lord, through this ache and sorrow and awareness into ones who do not let pain turn into apathy, but who instead are made more tender over time. Help us to work towards reconciliation, and so let us grow in our love for others, O Christ.
True justice is in your hands, especially when our human systems get it wrong. Still, your eternal judgments will be right. Help us to hold on to the light of your love, even in the darkness of the legacy of the residential schools.
Now make your redeeming mercies manifest, O Christ. Take away the evil of colonization, and by the movement of your Holy Spirit, heal the relationships between Indigenous and non-Indigenous people. Make a grander narrative display of beauty, grace, and restoration.
O Holy Spirit, hover now over the chaos of this broken world, this broken situation, and our broken hearts, and from them call forth new mercies and new hope. From fields seeded with human sorrows, let us one day collect a harvest of everlasting joys. From this stony soil of human hatreds, let fountains of divine love burst forth. Let streams of gladness run and pool. Let shoots of abundant mercy root and bloom over all this dark and weary land.
Let your eternal glories rise, radiant as a dawning sun, dispelling a black and tragic night. From this very heart of death, O God, call forth shalom for everyone and everlasting life. Amen.
Amen.